You know, I think IPO, while obviously everybody looks at it as a, it's a very important milestone for the company. I think it's a recognition of how far we've come. But business stays the same.
Yeah.
And at the end of the day, we've always focused on making sure we take care of patients, take care of our stakeholders, our investors, and that will continue as we speak. From a competitive standpoint, I think, I don't think anything is significantly different.
Hmm.
I mean, I think a few years ago, we saw a little bit of funding come into the industry,
okay,
either from private equity or from corporate groups who were interested in getting into diagnostics.
Hmm.
And that created a little bit of volatility in the industry because suddenly there was a little bit more capital in. I don't think it was ever very crazy.
Hmm.
But I think some of that has streamlined now because I think people have realized that this is not a business where capital is the biggest differentiator.
Okay.
In this business, actually trust your brand is your biggest asset.
Hmm.
And holding that, nurturing that, and making sure that on a daily basis you're doing what you're supposed to do is the most critical part of building this business, which is much harder to use than capital.
Okay.
So I think we're in a good space. I think we're in a strong leadership position. And I believe we're only going to grow from strength to strength.
So last time we spoke, we spoke extensively about how, the unorganized market is almost 85 to 90% is a big problem. And, we spoke to other diagnostic players and they also said that, certain norms that apply to you don't apply to them. And that's why they are able to pass on a lot of discounts. The other aspect which we didn't discuss is hospitals, because they as a part are also now getting into diagnostic, into testing. Do you see that as a major competition going ahead? Would that be a threat for diagnostic labs as such?
See, again, hospitals are experts at treatment.
Yeah.
We are experts at diagnostics, and that's why our brand positioning is also the pathology specialist.
Mm.
It's like asking me tomorrow if we go and start hospitals, does it give us an advantage to be in the hospital space? The answer is no.
Mm.
We understand healthcare, we understand diagnostics, the same way hospitals are really clued in on treatment.
Mm.
So we don't really are not experts in each other's areas.
Mm.
If, of course, somebody decides to get into the diagnostic space, then for them it is like anybody else getting into the diagnostic space, it's the new business.
Mm.
And they'll have to learn the dynamics from scratch.
What about the two aspects? I think we spoke that the B2C business seems to be doing stable, people coming in. How tough is it operating in the B2B scenario at this point of time?
See, the B2B side has two pieces of it, two product lines really. One is a semi-specialized product line and one is the specialized product line. In the semi-specialized product line is where you see basically mostly automated tests which don't have too much of expertise and scientific expertise requirement. So you see a lot of the new companies that have come into the industry have come into it competing in the semi-specialized space.
Okay.
We actually focus more of our attention on the specialized space,
yeah,
where we are actually there for people when they're trying to figure out whether somebody in their family has cancer, whether something really serious,
yeah,
is happening. In that situation, people are not looking at the cheapest price. They're actually looking at who's got the right quality report because they want to treat their family member. So from that perspective, I don't see the B2B as being something which is really eroding our value. In fact, for us, it's enhancing our value.
What about volumes? Are you looking to play the volumes game in this segment? Or are you looking to play the pricing game?
You know, we believe the volume and the pricing game actually goes together.
Hmm.
We believe there's a third part, which is the part that we are in, which is moving up the value chain segment.
Hmm.
So I think for us, while of course a healthy part of our revenue growth will come from volumes, some of it will also come through a change of test mix.
Hmm.
Because like I said, Metropolis is known for the credibility and the specialized tests,
hmm,
which tend to be at a slightly higher price than the normal routine tests. And as we see more and more of this mix changing, we will actually see our revenue growth also increasing because of that.
Okay. What about CapEx, sir? Because the IPO that happened, money will not come in. Are you fully funded to go ahead with your CapEx, your expansion plans? You must be looking at more laboratories. You must be looking at more touch points for the patient. Are you fully funded to go about that?
We are. So actually, we've been very comfortable with our internal accruals now for a long time. And, we are generating cash. We have almost a 50% EBITDA to cash flow conversion ratio. So therefore, we've had enough money not only to take care of our internal capex, but also to do small bolt-on acquisitions. So therefore, yeah, internal accruals-wise, we're fine.
What about financials? I know you can't give forward-looking statements, but generally, we've seen that there has been a slowdown as far as the run rate of top-line growth is concerned. At least we can look at the listed players that are there. Is that something that you're seeing, that the top-line growth probably won't be the same as it has been over the past few years?
Actually, for us, the top line growth that we are seeing in 18-19, for example, the numbers also that we've given out in the RHP has been higher than the top line growth we've seen in the last few years. So actually, we are in a slightly different stage because we are in a growth stage in our business. I don't want to comment on the competitors, but I think we are in different stages. So therefore, really for us, we feel that the growth rate that we are currently seeing, we believe would be very sustainable.
And how do you see margins? Do you see them stable? Do you see, and what exactly are you looking at, since this is a competitive space, that, margins can expand going ahead?
See, for us, I think if you look at it from a three-year perspective, we will largely see our margins being around the same. There is going to be some operating leverage that will come out of the B2C part contribution, our business really expanding. And there will be some operating leverage that will come from there. But we are also reinvesting that operating leverage into growth and really expanding our market share. So therefore, as we believe that we'll have over a three-year period very sustainable margins.